It's very ironic. Yeah, I still wasn't sure. The longer it went, I became more of a knowing a skeptic. I didn't think it was they maybe had enough to see to be able to call it a goal. I was convinced at the time when I saw it. I was just worried that the video wouldn't be conclusive. There was no call on the ice, so no call is a no goal. From the referee's perspective.
Sarah, about how much more time you have in the Vermont locker room?
You know, it was just a great moment for us when they came out of the penalty box. I think after the first overtime with Victor's goal, you know, they came out of the box and made it pretty quickly. So more steps they took out of the box without signaling no goal was starting to feel pretty good when he pointed to the dot. Obviously, it was pandemonium.
Can you talk about, do you feel like you redeemed yourself a little bit? You know, the way the hockey's postseason didn't end so well. It's looking pretty good now.
Well, I told our guys, we had a meeting Tuesday night after the Lowell series, and I pointed to teams like Denver, I don't even remember what year it was when they won the national championship, but I questioned our guys, said, who beat them in the quarterfinals? Knocked them out of WCHA playoffs. Nobody knows. So nobody's going to remember. You know, if you guys take advantage of the second opportunity, nobody's going to remember, the Lowell series. So they've done a great job. Our student athletes have done a great job. They're prepared. They soaked in everything we talked to them about in terms of game preparation and game planning, and they executed to a T. And I'm just very, very proud of our guys.
Coach, similar question to last night. You've been there as a player. How does it feel in comparison to maybe there as a coach?
Dean talked about the emotions of today. I was a little bit nervous for last night's game, but not that bad today. I couldn't rest. I couldn't sit still. Couldn't eat very well. I was pretty nervous because I just saw this was a great opportunity for us, and I wanted our student athletes to be able to taste the game. So it took me a while today to kind of calm the nerves down. They'll probably stir up again, going to DC. But again, I think we have a team that believes in themselves, and they play that hard together. Like they did this weekend for how many minutes we played, I'm not even sure, but they can beat anybody.
Coach, obviously, Rob's established himself as the number one goalie now, so 48 saves tonight. I mean, how proud are you of just the performance that he put in, and how impressed are you by it?
Well, he's continues to impress me every time I see him on the ice. His mental toughness as well as physical skills are well beyond his years. I mean, he looked like a senior. So we've landed a great student athlete. He's going to be a very good leader for our guys. Down the road, he's already doing a great job leading by example, but his presence, the way he calms our team down. We never look out there and say, oh, Rob's kind of having an off night there. He's fighting the puck. He's pretty smooth back there. So I'm very proud of his effort. He didn't have a great, he didn't feel like he was playing great the last couple of weekends, regular season, and then the playoff series against Lowell. He took the time to do what he needed to do with our goalie coach to rebound, so to speak. And he's done a great job there. He was sensational this weekend.
George?
Coach, you had the week off under very different circumstances after the Lowell series. Now you've got a week between now and when you go to Washington. How will you use the time? How will you approach this next week and a half?
Well, next day and a half, 2 days are rest days. Our athletes left it all out there. There's not a lot left in the tank. A lot of cramping going on. Some guys are banged up a little bit. So rest is an ally at this point of the season. And then we'll turn our attentions back on ourselves, because I think that's been a great approach by our staff, just what we need to do to be successful. And obviously we're going to be playing a Hockey East friend, so we'll have some familiarity there in game plan as we do this week.
Coach, the last few years you've been in the national picture without getting into the tournament. When you look at this team now that's going to the Frozen Four, and think about some of the guys who were part of those past teams who didn't get a chance to go there, how much would you say that the guys like the Jamie Cyphers, the Joe Fowles, the Torrey Mitchells have helped get the program to this point and their fingerprints on this?
They're instrumental. They really are. I mean, they helped build this program. Jamie Cyphers in particular is one of our early captains, helped build the culture. And my phone's going off the hook from those guys. So they're able to enjoy it as well as alumni. They feel a part of it, and they should. And I'm just real happy for our seniors. You know, I mean, those guys were so close for a couple of years there. They've been such standout student athletes for us that they deserve this. You know, I told the team in between the first and second overtime there that it's our time. We deserve it. You know, all the hard work that they've put in. There's no X's and O's to be talked about. They deserve it. And thankfully, we get to taste it.
Right. Hey, Coach, according to the stat sheet here, it says Air Force had about double the grade A opportunities, and unlike last night, they had an awful lot of shots. Did that surprise you? Do you feel like that was representative of the way the game was played?
At times, I felt like they mounted a great offensive attack against us. We kind of got caught with trying to be aggressive but not getting there. I thought they did an incredible job of taking us out as a five-man unit coming off the ice, so we were very disjointed coming off. We maybe had two guys on the rush. Weren't many times where we had three-on-twos. I think we went offside, you know, a bunch of times on three-on-two situations, which was disappointing. But I felt like all we had was situations where we could chip into the corner and then try to get into a forecheck. But we didn't come up with the ice with speed as a five-man unit. And that's credit to them. You know, again, I thought they played an incredible game. You know, Rob obviously had some game-saving moments for us, and that was probably the difference.
Right.